ప్రపన్నపాది జాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 25 ఆఫ్ 7th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ వాచ నాహం ప్రకాశ సర్వస్య యోగమాయా సమావృతః మూఢోయం నాభిజానాతి లోకో మామజమవ్యయం. ఇన్ ద వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 24 భగవాన్ గేవ్ అ క్లారిటీ ఫర్ సో మెనీ కాంట్రవర్సియల్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ భక్తాస్ లైఫ్. దీస్ కాంట్రడిక్షన్స్ అండ్ కాంట్రవర్సీస్ ఫౌండ్ వెన్ యూ లీడ్ ద స్పిరిచువల్ లైఫ్. The Krishna wants to give the clarity first. A devotee, when he could accept a form as the God, Krishna has the form. Because in our Sanatana Dharma, there are innumerable gods. Every deity has got its own specific forms. Rupa Visheshaha, Nama Visheshaha. And that is the glory of our Sanatana Dharma. Every Rupa, every form of the God, they have their own way of giving message and presenting a way of sadhanas. If you take Lord Ayyappa, Ayyappa who is also known as Harihara or Shasta, so there 18 numbers are specified. There are 18 steps. When you go to the temple and Lord Ayyappa is sitting in different posture, these 18 steps are main. People every year they should go to step by step. The first step for the first year, they have to cross 18 years. Then they can become Guru Swami. When you cross the 18 steps, you could see Tattvamasi. Written there, the word of Mahavakya. These 18 steps has got their own message to convey you. When you go step by step, you also get inner growth. Like every form has got its own message, first you should have the note in your mind. Therefore, you could see that there are different forms and names. They have their own paddhati, methods for worship. Okay? So that if you accept that, the controversial part comes. A devotee accepts one deity. He is able to accept one deity and he asks so many things, whatever he needs. Now the question is, why he asks for only the objects which are limited by time and space? Why he is not able to ask for the God? Why he sets only Sakama Bhakti? Sakama Bhakti means desire-oriented prayers. Why he is not able to come out of it? And why he is also not understanding the para prakriti of that form? When Krishna is the worshipping Lord, why he is only sticking with the form of Krishna? Even when you accept the Krishna, there are so many differences among the people. Certain people, they love only Bala Krishna, Gopala Krishna. The Gopala Krishna, so who is in Kerala? They worship only that Gopala Krishna. Other people, they only worship Radhe Krishna, Radhe Radhe Krishna, Radhe Krishna. And there are different between these people who worship Gopala Krishna, who people who worship Radhe Krishna. And there are certain people, they worship only the Bhagavad Gita Krishna, the Krishna in battlefield. You know, the worshipper of Radha Krishna, they don't worship Gita's Krishna. So this contradiction, why it happens? And why they are not able to ask for the ultimate good, moksha? So why this moksha is not attracted to them? Why they are attracted only towards the worldly life, even in the form of the God, they love to a particular form? Though they have come as the devotee, they continue with this kind of contradictions. Why? What is the reason? One thing. And there are abhaktas, there are non-devotees, means they don't accept any form of the God. They consider even Krishna, who was born as a human being, that's what we saw in the last session. They consider human being, he is born, Rama, who wasn't born. Rama is a Upasana Murti, Krishna can be the Upasana Murti, they don't accept. If that Upasana Murti is the God, if he is the creator, ask them to create one more world for me. The contradiction in the beginning stage, abhakta. Now Krishna just gives the answer. Because of the delusion, because of the extrovertedness. You know, extrovertedness means attracted to so many desires outside. They have lost their real life. They are victimized by the worldly perspective. That's what known as Mayaji. They are deluded. They are not bringing self-effort. So these abhaktas deluded completely by the God. And people who stick with only one form, they could accept Krishna alone, the deity. And they want to have darshan of Krishna. Means physical darshan of the Krishna. I have seen many sadhus, even when they are about to leave the body, they were longing for this darshan. Because Ramakrishna had Kali darshan, therefore I should have at least a small glimpse of the Krishna's darshan. Sticking with that only one form, they were not able to accept. Why? What happens to them? Still, though they are devotees, they are blessed, but they also deluded. But the difference between abhaktas and bhaktas, so bhaktas, these bhaktas are called sakama bhaktas. Their devotion is in the form of longing for the worldly object with the support of one form of the God. Abhaktas also cry, bhakta also cry. Abhakta cries everywhere. Okay, bhakta cries to get object with one place, one form. Now, what is the difference between the result both of them get? Abhakta will enjoy by his efforts. He continues with that samsara, but bhakta, he has got one process, that material process will be possible and spiritual process is not possible, but the spiritual stagnant will be their stagnation, what we call it. He don't fall from that place. But abhakta, there is a chance to fall from the human being. But this bhakta is safe, because he is dependent on the God himself to get the worldly things. He will get everything, but he won't fall from this state. He will continue with the materialistic life, but there is no progress in the spirituality. At the same time, no fall from the spirituality. That is a different. Bhagavan says, that's my anugraha, blessings. That's what he said. Yoga kshemam vahamyaham. I give the progress. At the same time, the devotee's part, you know, he should make self-efforts. He should get more growth inside. He should not stick with one form. Why he is sticking with one form? Because the abhakta, why he is not able to accept the form, there he said he is completely deluded because of his extrovertedness. But here he says, because the devotee has not learnt the principle, the higher principle of God, because God has got two principles. So he is sticking with the apara prakriti principle, but he is not aware about para prakriti principle. So he has to be informed of this para prakriti, then he will come to know, yes, there is a destination. Then the moksha destination will be attracted to him. No contradiction now. So just he has to be informed this para prakriti. Now once he is informed, Krishna has got, the Krishna form has got two kinds of principle. He will be enlightened. The Krishna's para prakriti and the Ranganatha's para prakriti, Venkateswara's para prakriti, Lord Shiva's para prakriti, Lord Ganesh para prakriti, Lord Lalita Tripurasundari's para prakriti, Lord Anjaneya's para prakriti, Lord Ram's para prakriti are one and the same. This apara prakriti may vary, therefore methods also vary, mantras are different, but all gods, they have the same para prakriti. Now he could grow a little bit more. That has to be informed. That's what Bhagavan says. This is the clarity in a various level of bhaktas, even to abhaktas. You should not to think there is the controversy, contradiction. You need not. There is no contradiction. The para prakriti must be informed to the devotee. Then he himself will to have the prayer for moksha. Prayer for moksha means what? So when he is able to find the limitation of the worldly things, automatically he will start asking God himself. That's what told by Krishna in these two verses, 24 and 25 verse. These two verses, they give the clarity. He says, so certain people are not accepting me as the God because I am born. They consider I am born as normal people because that is their finite nature. Because of the karma pala, that's because of my yoga maya. And certain people, they accept me as the God, but they are not able to accept other gods as me. So then this is again, it's a little bit grown people, but still they are not aware about my para prakriti. And that too is because of my yoga maya. That's what he says. So when there is a knowledge about para prakriti, that yoga maya can be crossed. Yoga maya means what? Trigunas. Yoga means here that which is connected with, that is the meaning, the connection with trigunas. So Bhagavan Krishna's message is, a devotee has to be informed about para prakriti. If he gets to know what is para prakriti, he himself will remove all the contradiction from his mind. He will start having a proper realm of journey which can lead to the proper destination. Nobody can stop it. That's what he said. Naham prakasha sarvasya yoga maya samavratah mudho yamna bhijanati loko mamajam avyayam. Mudaha aham na abhijanati. The completely deluded people, they cannot understand me. They still have to work to get punya. But these devotees, they should also understand my nature. My nature what? Avyayam, anuttamam, which is incomparable. Avyayam means that never subject to change. Avyayam mam na abhijanati. They are not aware about my real nature, which is paraprakriti. Then, who is in the form of prakashaha? Who is in the form of consciousness? Because of my yoga maya, they are deluded. So, they are deluded because of what? Trigunas, by apara prakriti. It can be said with a simple example, okay, that when you think about one object, you cannot think other object because your mind have no capacity. When you think about ice cream, you cannot think about something else because mind can have only one thought at given time. In the same way, here he says, so your mind being deluded because worldly object, when you think this house is my goal, this moksha goal won't be attractive. That's what. Now you see, sky has got stars and sun and moon. In the daytime, sun becomes dominant, therefore the stars are not visible. So when there is no sun, stars are visible. So when your desire towards worldly materials becomes more powerful, you believe that because of the house alone I will become secure, then moksha, because which gives ultimate security, won't be attractive. Because you started believing this object will give, this house alone will give security. After gaining the house, you become more insecure because in the house so many expenditures had happened. Because you are under debt, you should give back all the debt. Now you started, you are not able to sleep. You thought, you know, after constructing the house, I would sleep, I would have a very nice sleep. That's what your expectation. Now, in order to complete the debt, you are not able to sleep. So where is the security? You become more insecure, more restless. That's what the nature of the worldly object. But the mind, when it thinks the house is the object of the security, after gaining that, it will think something else is the place of security. That's what called the yoga maya. We have to be careful. Now Bhagavan just warns, so you should be careful with your mind system. That mind system is called the system of apara prakriti, the system of creation. That creation also is because of me. That's what I am teaching. The nature of the creation is like this. So you are a baby to me. You are a small boy to me. You are a small kid to me. Therefore, I am warning you, with be careful with trigunas. That triguna, it activates you, it drives you being in your system. Being a god, being a creator, being a kind of authoritative person to you, means being a ishta devata to you, my duty to make you understand the reality. That's what God does here. Next words, Vedaham samatitani vartamanani charjuna bhavishyani cha bhutani mam tu vedana kashchana. Here the God understanding only you can get through the scriptures. Okay? Then the God understanding in the ancient time, the God understanding at present, the God understanding in the future. So how it would be? So Bhagavan gives one more clarity about him. The time may vary. The yuga may change. You know, after 50 years, after hundreds of years, after millennium, so the people may get lots of improvement in technological life. technology wise we will be, you know, far better than now, but the God concept will be the same. Doesn't matter, this apara prakriti goes a different kinds of so many varieties of changes, but the para prakriti remains as it is. The point God gives here, you should not measure me through worldly object. Okay, if you want to understand me, so you have to undergo the scriptural way of studying about me. That's what he brings. Then also he gives, when you go under the scriptural studies, I will be very close to you. Otherwise, it is impossible. Even after thousands of years, it is impossible. Because when you go to a guru, you surrender, then when he teaches step by step, step by step, step by step, you should have the concentration, focused mind. For that, you should have the Ishta Devata, the deity, to be given with a form. Then you started focusing in that form, you will get a focused mind. Then through that form alone, you will be explored the unform of the God. Means the godliness which is beyond the form will be explored to you. Your mind also will get the capacity to assimilate God in the form of Nirguna. I say in the form of Nirguna means God doesn't have the form. Means whatever the forms are available here, which is nothing but apara prakriti, so they all of them are nothing but God. That is the connection with the verse number 26. Actually, he is concluding the subject matter which he began from verse number 21, Sakama Bhaktaha. So Sakama Bhakti and Sakama Bhaktaha, one who is having bhakti. The bhakti he uses to get whatever he wishes as the worldly things. And bhakti means one more meaning. Not one more meaning, that is the main meaning. Bhakti means love. So love. When you experience the love, when you go in front of the deity, you should have that the love experience in you. That's what the communication. So with that love, when you share something, when you ask something, he is ready to provide anything you want, everything you want, but you should be aware what to ask, when to ask. And if you are aware about his two principles, you will be a finely tuned bhakta. You can utilize the bhakti. Through the bhakti, you will definitely set the ultimate goal and reach ultimate goal too. And therefore, my prayer, so all of us should grow actually to be as a great bhaktas. Whatever the deity that you worship well. At the same time, try to understand the para prakriti principle of that deity, because all deities have got only one para prakriti. So by learning it, so you will become like a naishkarmya bhakta, a bhakti which is endowed with naishkarmya attitude. Okay, that we will continue from the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.